Ciao. Thank you, everyone. Other interesting business news, you have Tesla. Their sales dropped by more than 60,000 vehicles for Q1. That is not great. Now, that being said, the government's also outlawing internal combustion engines in the United States via de facto emission bans. So the government's doing, and you have that $7,500 tax rebate. The government's doing, they're pulling every lever they can to try to push EVs on the American public. And yeah, there are some organic demand in terms of people who would want an electric vehicle. But the biggest overwhelming contributing factor is the government, which again they've done that throughout time with different industries and pushing different initiatives, so it's not a new thing. Now, with this Tesla, they're getting so desperate. We covered this earlier, last or earlier in the week. It's one of those instances where even Tesla's starting to pay for advertisements, which historically they never really did. Statistically speaking, they spent nothing, and then I think in 2020 they spent like 75 grand. Which for them was nothing, relatively speaking. Then they increased it by like 3,000% to a couple million dollars on the Facebook. So again, they're starting to suffer in terms of they have real competition now. They have a couple, wholly electric companies like Rivian who's starting to challenge them, and you also have the legacy auto manufacturers who are catching up. So I mean, some people are buying the Ford trucks. They're electric. Yeah, the Ford Mustang E-Mach, for the people who don't know what a real Mustang is, or just hate themselves maybe. And then you have General Motors making stuff, allegedly. They sell things. Kidding, partially. But they do have their electric vehicles that some people appreciate. But again, at the end of the day, right now Tesla's a luxury item costing, $50, $60, $70,000 plus. Again, like Rivian, like most automobile companies, they're trying to get a entry-level economic EV in the market sooner rather than later. The rumor is $24,000 price point, what they're hoping for. Which again, with newer technologies and newer efficiencies, they might be able to get to that price point. I mean, the big elephant or panda in the room is though China, where they have the BYD, which is a manufacturer out of China, where they have a $10,000 EV, which would basically destroy everyone when it comes to a price competition, because you're not going to beat China when it comes on price. They have a much better business-friendly environment. They don't have more red tape than a dictionary, and they also, actually incentivize business. The businesses aren't kneecapped by the government. They also have, a lot of things working for them, less regulation. You have the EPA shutting down factories in China. That's definitely not happening. Though they are kneecapping, they're actually, the antithesis, they're actually expanding their energy capacity in China. But I partially digress. Going back to Tesla, now Elon Musk said it delivered 386,810 vehicles in the first 3 months of FY 2024, ending March 31st, which is down 20% from the previous year, previous, sorry, quarter. And down 8.5% from a year ago, which, again, on average, doesn't matter. Well, it always, so to a certain extent, it matters who's running for president of the United States. But usually, most businesses during the election year, the sales decrease because everything decreases. Really, it's just uncertainty in the market, which is what kills a lot of most spending initiatives. Businesses themselves decrease on their internal research development. They usually decrease on their spending, and a lot of consumers do the same thing. Also doesn't help that you got 40 year plus, or what is it, 40 year high hyperinflation in the United States. That's not helping anyone, thanks to the ineptitudes of the Republicans and the Democrats. Now, you also have Tesla saying that they missed the consensus of Wall Street estimated 449,080 deliveries, but so they missed it by more than 62,000 vehicles, its largest margin to date. Which, again, once you're publicly traded, one of the biggest things that could hurt or help you is missing or exceeding Wall Street expectations. People will sell the stock just because they missed this goal. I mean, and actually now that I think about it, see, perhaps it didn't dent them at all, but if we pull up their stock for the, their stock dropped 7.86% over the past couple of days earlier this week, which, again, that's not insignificant. That's a pretty big dip. And again, you look at the top, we just go on the Brave or go on the Google and you just, search Tesla stock or Tesla, and the first one, two, three, four, five, six, like an overwhelming majority of these articles are talking about the drop in deliveries, because again, that's also a drop in sales. And one of the worst things possible about technology, or when it comes to research, when it comes to investing in technology, you now have those assets just sitting around and depreciating, and with technology moving so quickly, they could become worthless. This is what made Dell really successful. Michael Dell, they had the just-in-time delivery mechanism or methodology, where traditional computer companies would, they manufacture, let's say, 10,000 PCs or 10,000 laptops and desktops, they throw them in a warehouse and they try to sell them. Well, computers move so quickly in terms of research development and becoming more efficient, faster. If you don't sell them quickly, they are worth nothing just because newer tech is more efficient, it's cheaper. Now you have that warehouse full of junk. Now, of course, electric vehicles don't move quite as quickly as computers, though they are glorified computers on wheels. That's another issue that I'm actually surprised not more of these articles are bringing up in terms of significance. And in fact, they actually specify in this Yahoo Finance article, specifically the stock fell by 5.6% due to this news. And let's see, they say that BYD, of course they mentioned BYD pursuing an aggressive pricing strategy, trying to take some Tesla's market share. But even BYD looks like, fell short of BYD's rivals. They actually did, they put out 526,000 vehicles, geez Louise, during the same time period. Which BYD does have hybrids as well, so the numbers might be a little bit skewed, of course. But it's not great news for Tesla when they used to be, I think most people could still consider them an industry leader, but they are starting to give a lot of competition and you have this bad economy. I don't know anyone, anecdotally speaking, I don't know anyone who's going out and buying a new vehicle, yet alone an expensive luxury EV. It's just, as some might say, not in the cards these days. They'll let me know, do you think Tesla is going to, make a comeback Q2 this year? Do you think their sales are going to go off the charts? Or do you think the government will have to do some type of extra spiff, or instead of a $7,500, tax rebate, they do a 10, 20, 30 grand. It's all tax money. Why not? They'll just say, oh yeah, we'll just give it away. It'll be interesting to see, or if the government just makes, internal combustion engines illegal, which they are slowly but surely doing with their mandates. And so be interested to see what the future is for Tesla, but it's not every day you see them have a hiccup, so to say, and those hiccups are slowly starting to add up. Be fascinating to see what happens to Tesla, but as I always say, time shall tell. Thank you everyone for taking the time to tune in. Again, we're trying to get to 4,000 subscribers by the end of the month, so if you could click that button, I would greatly appreciate it. Also, leave me a thumbs up, a thumbs down, or a comment. It's a great way to give me some additional feedback, as well as sharing the video with your friends, so it'll help with the YouTube and Rumble algorithms. Lastly, don't forget to take the time to tell your family, tell your friends, tell your coworkers, heck, tell your enemies, tell anyone and everyone. Just stay safe and fight the good fight.